嗨，大家好，我是古阿沃，今天要用40分钟来教你 Cyber Security 的 Lab6。
We all know that there are so many kind of file types out there. We have Word document, we have PDF file, we have Excel file, we have binary files, we have EXE file, we have Python code, we have, I need more fingers. And with so many kind of file types, sometimes it can really get kind of confusing, like what kind of file type that I'm dealing with. So for example, just looking at an image file can be in a bitmap format, can be a most common JPEG format, or like PNG format. And for us, people like researcher and forensics analysts, when we are trying to do some investigation, one of the most important things that we have to find out would be what are the files that we are dealing with. And this can be tricky because, as we have just said, there are just too many of them. So it is really important for us to know some tips and tricks and some really handy tools that we can always rely on and use if you want to quickly find out like what is the file type of this file that I'm currently working with. Okay, now, what if I tell you most of the data type that we are currently using has one thing in common, which is we can actually recognize them by looking at the very first few bytes of this data, because that's where we can find the header of the file. So the header means for every kind of file, they always start with a certain bits or bytes that looks exactly the same for that kind of file type. And that is what we call the signature, where we can really use to identify based on this pattern. This could be a JPEG or a bitmap or a PNG. So that is the header signature. So you can download the Lab6 kit from the link down below, which will include all the files and folders, including the lab manual that you need to do this lab. Now, the very first thing that you should do will be to make a backup copy of this folder files that contains 10 different files. And this is really important because in a short while, we will be messing with some of these files. And just in case if things goes wrong, it is always good to have some backup that we can always come back to. So that's what I'm going to do. First thing is I'll make a copy of this file and then I'll paste it on my desktop. So in this lab, you'll find 10 challenges, which we are going to go through together. I'll be showing you how I crack each of these challenges using some of the tools. Some are online, some you have to install, that I found really, really useful and speed this up by quite a bit. So let's get started. Question 1. What is the original file type of GOTM? So let's get back to the directory where you keep all the files earlier. So mine is in the files on the desktop. And we are talking about the first one, GOTM. Sounds like Game of the Millennium to me. So first thing, you notice that this is currently an unknown file type. There are no extension behind the file, so we really couldn't tell by now. And we can also try to get into the properties of the file to find out more. And again, yeah, it is just an unknown file, so nothing really much here. Now, two things could happen here. First, this file, this could be a working file. In any format, it could be a text file, it could be a PDF file, it could be an EXE file. Just that currently the extension of this file is missing, which is why the OS doesn't detect what is this file type and doesn't know what to do with this. Now the second thing could be this file is really corrupted, which is why it is not possible for the OS to detect what is the current file type. And if that happened, instead of just throwing that thing away, there is still a chance where we can repair that file and try to recover that, and we will get into that in a short while. So now I'm going to show you two different tools that I find it to be really useful that you can use to quickly ID what is the file type for any unknown file. So it depends on whether you want to use an online tool or you would like to install a program. So for this example, I'll be showing you a program that I have installed, which is called Try. It could be, I don't know, Try to ID or something. So this is how the program looks like. And if you would like to learn how do I install this, there is descriptions on how you can install this. So you need two things for this to work. Of course, the first thing would be the treat.exe. That would be what we'll be running. And then you need to have this TRD file, which is actually the definition file. So just like virus, we have all the signature to ID different kind of viruses. We have the same definition file for this program that contains all the file type headers, as we have said earlier, so that this program will be able to detect and try to guess what kind of file that we are dealing with by looking at the first few bytes of a certain file. And hopefully the thing is not corrupted, then this program, as far as I try, is really really accurate so far. It has been giving me about 8 positive guesses out of 10 that I'm trying on it. So this is a really great tool. So let's try to see how it works. Now I'm running this on a Windows 10. So if you're running on a different OS like a Linux, you might want to check out how it is used. So first thing, just drag and drop this program here. Instead of typing the full path, because I'm always doing it in a lazy way, to tell Windows to run the track.exe program. And since I'm just dragging and drop, there's no need for me to specify where is this program located right now, because dragging and drop also show all the full path in the command prompt here, which is really handy. Now the next parameter here would be the file that you are trying to guess. So over here, it would be the GTOM file. So over here, this will be the GTOM file. So I will just drag and drop again here, and yeah, that's pretty much it. Press enter. Okay, now it doesn't detect. Okay, now that is not the start that I'm hoping for, to be honest. But what we can tell from here is that most likely the file that we are currently having could be corrupted, which is why the file identifier is not be able to detect what is the current file type. So in that case, another way would be using a WinHex. Okay, now so for this question, I'll be using WinHex. So now if you're looking for a really good tool that can help you in recognizing what are the file types, and in some cases even repairing a corrupted file, then WinHex is a really good choice. So for question 1, GOTM, it's really easy to use. I'll just drag and drop this file that I'm trying to recognize into WinHex, and you will see WinHex is currently showing us the content of the file in the hexadecimal representations. Okay, now since we are trying to guess what file this is, there's a very useful function here called analyze file under tools analyze file, where WinHex will now show you the signature file, the file signature in a visual representation. So the trick here is that for different kind of files, when we run them through this analyzer to show their kind of heat map visual, every file will give you a different kind of visual representation. And this is one way we can use to compare with a reference that we already have and try to guess what are the files that we currently have. Of course, for this to work, you will have to have a reference for you to compare these visuals to. So in our case, there is already a few in the lab manual. Of course, you can find more online. So let's see whether this is helpful. Now, let's compare this side by side here. So the first one is JPEG. It is somewhat similar, but it's not really alike because you have more consistency at the bottom area. So this might be it. We'll come back to this later. It could also be, okay, now this is definitely not a bitmap. This is definitely not an audio file. And yeah, I think this one, the normal compressed data, this is more like it. So you can see all the spikiness on the top regions, and at the bottom it is all like all blue. So it's really consistent. So my guess would be this could be a compressed file. Okay, now there's something in the right direction, but of course we are still a few steps away because there are like so many kinds of zip file, RAR file, 7-zip, and we still have to try that out in a short while. So since we have already guessed that this is a zip file, we will now go back to GOTM and then just rename this with a .zip extension so that the OS will now know this is actually a zip file. So after this, I guess everybody is already curious what we have inside the zip file. So let's just sort of unzip the file here, and oops, we get an error message. Now, this could mean that although we already know that this is a zip file, but it could still be corrupted, which is one of the reasons why when we try to unzip, it doesn't really work. So in that case, we will have to check whether the header of this zip file is corrupted or not. So since we know that we are not doing this right, we have to first remove this empty folder first. And for this zip file, we want to change it to the original unknown file before we go to the next step. So the next thing we do is to check the file header to see whether this zip file is corrupted or not. To do so, you'll need to use the list of signature file, which I have already included in the link down below. So it's a PDF file. Download that, keep it with you, because that will always come in handy when we are doing some forensics, file recovery, and file analysis. So I actually got this file straight from Wikipedia, but I put it in PDF. So you can even use this even if you're not online. And so this file shows us all the hexadecimal value of different file headers for many different file types. So the way to use this is really easy. So for example, let's say if you have a bin file, the file header should always start with 53503031, and that is the original notation. So let's say if you have a bin file with a header signature that is somewhat different from 53503031, that could be a sign that this file is corrupted. Now in our case, since we already guessed that this is a zip file, so we'll do a quick search on zip to find what is the correct header. Now, but over here we have to be careful because there are so many kinds of zip files, and I really want to try with the most common one, which is the .zip. So this is not the one, this is actually another kind of zip format. Not this one, this is a bzip2, not this one. And yeah, this is the one that we are looking for. The most common zip file format that we all has been using so often in any Windows operating system. Now over here on the left, these are all the correct signature, and we have three options here. So the first one is the default options, and then the second one here is actually for the empty archive, so it's an empty zip. And the last one is a span archive, which is you have a big zip file and then you break them into a few smaller ones, so that is for a span archive. So in our case, I think most likely we should be going with the first one here, 504B0304. So the next thing we do is that we are going to try to repair this file by restoring the header of this file into the original format here. So I'll go back to WinHex, and then you simply point your cursor here to start from the very first hex value here, and just type in 504B0304. And if we are right, then this should do the trick. So click on the save button here to change the value of the file header, and that's pretty much it. And then we go back to GOTM. So we'll do the same again. Rename this to a .zip extension so that it becomes a zip file, and try to extract it. Yeah, this time it works. So it works really. So as you can see here, this is the unzip folder, GOTM. Go in and we have another file inside this zip file. Now before that, just take a second to explain that what happened here is the first time when we try to do the same thing, which is by renaming this to a .zip, it doesn't work because although we got the file format correctly, any program that we are using to unzip doesn't recognize the header. So we have a little bit of problem there, and by changing the header value, we restore the zip file into the correct format. Okay, and then now it works. But hey, there's another file here. So as you can tell, things are not looking easy, and after 10 minutes, we are still in the first questions. Anyway, let's try to finish this up. So we have another GOTM, and most of the people will be thinking, yeah, this is just another zip file. It could be a zip inside a zip, and you might want to try this if you think that is correct. If you trust your sixth sense, it might work. And then if I try to extract, it doesn't work. So that means this is wrong. So for you to go back to the original file, you can actually press the Ctrl Z button to undo the renaming, so that I get back the original file without the zip extension, and then I can try again. So now it is very clear that this is not a zip file, otherwise it would have worked. And the next thing that I would want to do is to try to recognize the file type. Now for this challenge, I'll be using a tool called Try ID. So to use this, you simply have to drag and drop this .exe file to your command prompt instead of typing them in full. And the next thing would be the file that you are trying to guess. So I'll go back to where I have all my files, go to GOTM, which is the file that the folder that we have just unzipped earlier, and I'll just do the same, drag and drop this into the command prompt, press enter, and in a short while we should get the file type, because I guess it is running through. Yeah, it is done. So it has scanned about 13,000 of signature. Well, that's really a lot of file types here. And from the result, we can guess this is most likely an .exe file. Now, of course, this is no right or wrong, because everything is a guessing game. But normally, we would always try with the best guess. And here is an .exe file. So in that case, I'll come back and rename this to n.exe. Okay, now. Again, our curiosity is asking us to click on this program, but remember earlier we said that what if this is a virus? Now, if this is a virus, double click on it, gone. It's going to be a really short video. Cut. Now, of course, the right way to do this would always to run this in a sandbox, as what we have learned in the previous video, so that if health breaks loose, everything will still be contained in the sandbox. Now in this case, it doesn't really matter, so I will double click on here, and you can see, yeah, in fact it is not anything harmful here. It's just a program that print a line, you got the marks. Yeah, I think over here it is really self-explanatory. We got it, okay, we got it. So this is the first challenge. After I rename this to an .exe file, I just run it and it opened up a command prompt. It shows me the message, you got the marks. Now coming back to the question here, what is the original file type of GOTM? So I think for this question, it might be referring to the GOTM inside the zip file. So the answer here would be a .exe file. Okay, question number two. What is the message contained inside HW? So let's get back to the folder where you kept all the files, and yeah, we are going to use this HW file. So again, this is an unknown file, and we can use the trick we learned earlier. Try to ID what file type this is by using the try ID here. So the way I do this is the same. Go to the folder where you have your tryid.exe, drag and drop. So that will give us the first parameter, spacebar, and then you just drag and drop the file that you are trying to recognize here, which is HW. So if you have two parameters that is ready, hit enter. Yeah, it is really quick. And we already have our result here. This is most likely to be an .exe file again. So yeah, why not? Let's try this HW, and then I'll rename this. I'll be adding an extension here, .exe. To make it into an executable file, and then we'll just double click to run this. Yeah, I'll just run this because this is not my PC anyway, so who cares? Run, and we got it! This is like somewhat way easier than what we have in the first question. Just one trick, find the file type is a .exe, rename that, and then you run it and you get a command prompt that shows hello world. So let's go back to the question. What is the message contained? So over here, this is really a clear cut one. the message that we got is hello world after running the executable file. Question 3. Repair Lab6.doc. Alright, so this is something a little bit different. This time we have to repair a file. And remember, we have also done something similar in question 1 where we have repaired a zip file. But this time we'll be doing this for a .doc file. So let's go back to the folder where you keep all the files here and then look for lab6.doc. So I'm thinking that this one might be corrupted. So let's leave, but before that, why not just try to open this one and yeah, now we are sure that this is corrupted, which is why your Microsoft Word is not able to decode the character types here. So we won't be able to see the content just yet. So to fix this, we'll use WinHex. And then I would suggest you to close all the other files that you had previously before you start the new one. So let's drag this Lab6 into WinHex. And then we will have to find out what is the correct file header for a .doc file. So again, using the PDF file that you got from the link down below, this time we'll be searching for a .doc file instead of a zip file. So I type a .doc in find and then let's go through one by one. So over here I have already got a hit here, a docx here, which is having the same header as the zip file that we got earlier in question 1. But yeah, there's a trick here. I think this is a trap. Like I always say, if things are too easy, that is definitely a trap. And yeah, remember here is actually showing a docx, which is a newer version of a Word document. And for our case, it is actually a .doc file. So they are really, really different, although they are all both Word document, but they are having different file signature. So we have to keep searching. And then let's go on and on and on. Here we got it. A .doc file. So this is what we are looking for actually. And the header here is a little bit long. We start from D0, CF, until we have E1 at the end. So next thing we do would be to try to repair this file by changing the header value here. So I'm back to WinHex and I'll just type in the file header exactly as I see in the PDF file. So it is D0 CF 11 E0 slow and steady, slow and steady here. You don't want to mess up the file. A1 B1 1A E1. Yeah, so I think that's pretty much it. Next, click on the save button here to repair that file. And then let's try to open this file again. Yeah, and we got it. This time it works. So it looks like it is actually a lab manual without anything. It's just a lab manual, empty lab manual. Okay. So what do we have to show here? So the question is asking us to repair, so we have done the repair work. So most likely it is asking us what is the content of the file. So we can just copy and paste this whole thing as the answer for question 3. Question 4. So what is the file type of making tips? Okay, let me say that again. What is the file type of making tips? Okay, I have to got this right, otherwise this video will be banned by YouTube. Okay, so I guess something similar. We have an unknown file and then we are supposed to guess what it is. But a TIFF is in fact already a file type. A TIFF is a format for an image file. Something like similar to JPEG and bitmap, TIFF is another popular image file format. So in fact, if you want, you can just try to rename this to .tif. See if it works. So I've done this, double click, and then try to open this with any program that can open an image file. It doesn't work. Yeah, that means okay, this is a wrong guess. Let's U-turn, Control Z, U-turn to get back to the original file. And I guess we still have to do it the hard way. Okay, now I'm going to show you one new extra tool here, which is something similar to Try ID, but this is an online tool. So you can navigate to this toolsly.com. The link is already added down below And this is exactly similar thing for people who have active internet connections and you don't want to install anything on the machine. You can use this online tool. So it's as simple as drag and drop your file here and you will see what is the file type. So in fact, it is like too easy, a PDF file. Okay, so let's go back to our folder here and then just try to rename this to a .pdf and let's see whether it works. Okay, it works. So we got it here. Again, this is a PDF file, making teeth using, okay, I'm not sure whether we are supposed to read the content or not. It's a really long PDF. So normally what I do with a long PDF is I will just close it here. Now let's go back to the questions here. What is the file type? So you already got it earlier. It's actually a .pdf file, and which is why we can open the file in an Adobe Reader after renaming the file into a .pdf file. Question 5. What is the file type of math? We have an unknown file. You are trying to guess what is the type of the file. So far we have already seen two different ways. You can either use a tryid.exe or you can also use the Toolsly, which is an online file detector. And of course, for those who are feeling adventurous, you can always use the binhacks to analyze the visual signatures and then try to compare them with a set of visuals that we already have. So in this case, I'm going to use Toolsly because that is actually the easiest way. So let me just drag and drop this into Toolsly here. So man, which is for question 5, drag and drop, is a PC bitmap. So it is, I think, an image file. So let's try to rename this to a bitmap file. .bitmap. Is that bitmap? I think it is BMP. So let me try BMP here. And open the file. Yeah, we got it. First try, we got it. So this looks like me when I first woke up, especially for the hair part. So we have already solved for the first one. We will go straight to the next one, which is man 2 here. And doing the same, I will just drag and drop man 2 into Toolsly to detect what is the file type here. It's a raw data. That means it doesn't work. Okay, now I have also tried this with the tryid.exe. It doesn't tell us anything except it is kind of an image file, an Adobe Photoshop brush. Now here it says this is a .avr file, but you should know that this is most likely a false alarm. Okay, because most of the time for an image file that's corrupted, when this file detector is trying to guess, and they cannot get the exact file type like a JPEG or GIF or bitmap or PNG, then most likely they will tell you that this is a .avr file. So based on experience, I am guessing this is a false alarm. So this could be really some other image file. And yeah, there's no shortcut here except to try this out one by one by fixing the header and try whether we can open the file. And if it doesn't work, we have to try with another file header. So let's start with all the popular image file here. And yeah, let's try to do an image search. Image. And then we have a GIF. So the first hit that we got here is GIF, and we have two possible extensions here. It could be the GIF87A or GIF89A, because there are just two variants of GIF. So of course, since we don't have any other clue, we'll just have to try this out one by one. So I'll start with the first one. And I'm going to repair this file based on the file signature here. So 47 49 46 38 37, slow and steady. 43761. Yeah, that's pretty much the signature. Click on the save button here. And if this is the right one, then we are supposed to be able to open the file. So I fixed the header. I will rename this to .gif because I'm trying out for GIF this round. So normally I would like to pray first. Please let me open this file and then double click. It works! My prayer is answered. Santa is real. So this is another image that just like the one we had earlier. But yeah, the cool thing is that it works in our first try, in our first file header. what are the odds? Now going back to our questions here, for number 5, it is actually a bitmap file. For number 6, we already find out it is a GIF, a .gif file. But if I remember correctly, GIF file is supposed to move around, right? And now we are only getting a static file. I'm not sure why, but anyway, let's go on to the next one. Alright, now question 7. What is the password inside network pass? So I'm guessing this is a file. This is the file here that contains a password. So again, unknown file type. And to use the easiest way, I will use pushly. Just drag and drop this file here. Oops. Use this password to add. Well, is that that simple? What have I done here? I just drag and drop this file just like that, and it opens the file. Use this password. So this is the password that we are looking for. So in fact, we don't even need to know what is the file type. And I think this is the Eureka moment that we are talking about. I don't know how it works. Sometimes it just works. So I have accidentally drag and drop this file into my Google Chrome, and then it opens up this file and we can straight away get the password here. So this actually answers for our question 7. The password is np1xw62ae4. Alright, question 8. What is the message contained inside Ookla 2? So let's go to Ookla 2 again, an unknown file type. So I'm doing this again. And since last time I'm so lucky, I'm just going to drag and drop this file to my browser again. Maybe I got lucky for the second time. Oops, doesn't work. Okay, that's fine. So now we'll drag this Ookla 2 into Pusli, and it shows a corrupted file. Now since Pusli doesn't work, now I'm going to try this thing with try ID. So I drag and drop my try ID, I place it on my desktop here, followed by a spacebar, and then now the files that we are trying to guess, which is Ookla 2, press enter, and yeah, this time it works. So I'm guessing there is a difference here. The online tool might not have that much of signature, which is why it doesn't really detect this one. And as I use try-id.exe, it says it could be an Excel file. So let's try to rename this to .xls here. Go to Ookla to rename this with the extension .xls, press enter, and double click to open this file. And yeah, it works. We are getting the momentum here, like everything we try it just worked, and the message here is I think this is wrong, ABBDE, I think this is wrong. So is this the right one? Okay, it shows us the message is I think this is wrong, ABBDE. So should we be reading this literally like this is really wrong, or this is just the message that says I think this is wrong? Yeah, if you are overthinking, then you might be thinking this is the wrong clue. But as for this video here, I guess we'll just take this as the correct answer. So for question number 8, the message is I think this is wrong, which even sounds odd when I read it out loud. Okay, question number 9. What is the file type of menu? So again, something very similar. I think we are getting a hang on this right now. And for venue, I'm going to use try-id because I didn't have a good experience with Tusli the other in the previous example here. So treat.exe, drag and drop your venue here, press enter, and it seems that this is an ASCII file. ASCII file is just any text file, so which means it could be a .txt file. So I'll rename this to a .txt, and maybe it is that easy. Double click, and yeah, we got it. Got it, first try. So looks like a file that tells us the lecture theater venue. I don't know, this could be from a timetable from this semester or next semester or from the future, but at least we got it. And now we know that this is actually a text file because the try-id tries to tell me that this is a text file. So the file type here is a .txt file. So we are finally in the last question, 10. And now there are two ways to do these questions. One way is that now for the innocent way, most of the people here will try to repair man 3, woman 1, and woman 2. And all these three are images file. Once you recover them, you can open these three images, put them side by side, and then you can compare whether do they look the same. Now I have to tell you that even though you have all the images in front of you, sitting in front of you, you shouldn't really trust your eyes that much. Especially all the stories that you see on Instagram, most of them are really scripted. So the right way, the scientific way to do this would be to use a hash analyzer. So the trick here is that if you have two files that are actually identical, exactly the same files, if you run these two files through some hash analyzer, doesn't matter what hash algorithm that is, it could be MD5, it could be SHA, it could be decrypt, they will give you exactly the same hash value. So the intuition here is that two same files go through the same hash algorithm, you should get two same hash value. So in our case, we can just run these three files through a hash analyzer and then we compare whether they are having the same hash value. Now to do so, BinHacks already have a hash analyzer built in. So what I really do is that I'm going to open the notepad file and this is where I will record all the hash value here. The man 3, woman 1, woman 2. Now the next thing left to do here is to get the hash value. So open up your BinHacks and then we'll start to drag and drop all the files that we're comparing for now. The first one would be man 3, so I'll drag and drop this, go to the tools here, compute hash, and then you can just choose any hash of your choice. I'll be using MD5, which is the most common one, and this is my hash value. So I'll copy this so that later on I can come back and then I'll compare this with the other one. So I'm done with man 3. Close this one. I really have two more things to do here. Woman 1 in. Compute hash. Of course you have to make sure that you use the same MD5 as the one that we have just used earlier. And copy this hash value here. Then the last one here will be for woman 2. 2's compute hash, MD5, and then I got the hash. So I got all three hash here. The last thing that I need to do here would be to compare whether they are the same. Now of course, my eye tell me that the first two is the same. Man 3 and woman 1 is actually having the same hash value. Now if you are too lazy to compare this, you can actually just run them through to a notepad++, try to compare all the strings whether they are exactly similar. But I guess this is really easy. This is something that I can trust in my eye. They are the same. So I think the trick here is not to be deceived by the file name. As you can see, man 3 and woman 1. Yeah, one is man, one is woman. Most likely are different. But you know, sometimes you cannot tell whether this is really a man just by looking at the face. Sometimes it could be a woman. Sometimes it could be the other way around. Okay, I don't want to go there, but yeah, the trick here is not to just jump into conclusion, but always to use a scientific way or a scientific tool to really validate what you're trying to check for. Alright, so of course for the last one here, this is actually having a different hash value. So even the file names look like, okay, you have two women, it could be the same woman, it could be the different woman, but from this hash value, it really tells us that these are really, really two different file with two different hash value. So coming back to question 10 here, I guess the answer would be man 3 and woman 1 are the same file, just that they have different file names. The content is exactly the same, otherwise you wouldn't get the same hash value, and woman 2 is a different file from them. So I guess that is pretty much everything that you have to do for this big challenge. So I guess that's pretty much everything that I'm going to show you for all the labs in this cybersecurity labs. Thank you for joining me since day one. I hope you have learned something new. Security is fun. I hope you really enjoy this one. If you like this video, help me to smack the like button. And I'll see you In the future video, where we'll be talking even more advanced stuff about cybersecurity. So, wish you a Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. Bye bye. Peace out.